map with 50 states renamed for countries with similar gun ownership, wild. What would the United States look like if we had a map naming the 50 states as the countries around the world with the same gun ownership? How does your state fare on gun ownership? The left is at it again on taking guns away from lawful citizens in the name of sanitizing the world of its problems. There's only one reason to take away from the people the one thing they can use to protect themselves. What will allow them to take everything else? It's about control. Control healthcare. Control schools. Then get those guns. Thankfully, Americans throughout this country aren't willing to give up their Second Amendment rights. From Movoto. In the wide world of weaponry, is your state more like the relatively pacifist Solomon Islands or global superpowers China and India? Check out the approximate number of guns owned per state. As per this illustrative map. So, where do we stand in the right to bear arms discussion? Well, truth be told, we here at the Movoto Real Estate blog would rather play with numbers and offer everyone an interesting perspective of the issue. That said, what, we asked, would it look like if we compared gun ownership in our 50 states with gun ownership in other countries? You can see our answer above, and read about how we arrived at it below. Methodology, what triggered our conclusions? We started with a research group in Switzerland called Small Arms Survey in its report Small Arms Survey 2007, Guns and the City. Among other things, it estimated gun ownership numbers for 178 countries, including the United States, which it estimates has about 270 million guns. We then took the estimate of 88.8 guns per 100 people for the U.S., which, 7 years later, is likely higher, and used it to calculate each state's estimated gun ownership, based on state populations from the U.S. Census Bureau's 2010 survey. Of course, gun ownership density varies throughout the country, but this number gave us an easy way to come up with comparable figures for all 50 states, since actual state-to-state numbers were not available. Once we had the list of state numbers, we compared each one to Small Arms Survey's list of countries and respective gun ownership estimates, logging the nearest match. Find your own safe house. If all this talk of guns is making you nervous, try to relax knowing the odds are reasonably slim that you'll die from a firearms assault, 1 in 356, or from a firearms discharge, 1 in 6,509, according to the National Safety Council's Injury Facts 2014 edition. And if you're really concerned, and want to improve your odds, take a look at our latest ranking of the safest places in America for some better places to park. The Founding Fathers understood some basic concepts that have withstood the test of time throughout history. Man has the incoherent right to protect himself and his family. Criminals do not obey laws. You cannot sanitize the world of its problems. Gun control does not work. I will repeat. Two buildings and two signs. One says, "No guns allowed," and the other says, "We're packing." Which building will a thug decide to enter for nefarious purposes? Devin Patrick Kelly, 26, who murdered 26 in a Texas Baptist church, had been denied a Texas gun permit through gun control, according to Governor Abbott. Kelly had previously served in the U.S. Air Force, and was stationed at Holloman Air Force Base in New Mexico from 2010 until his discharge in 2014, an Air Force spokesperson confirmed. Those who knew him said he was creepy, crazy, and weird. Kelly was also court-martialed in 2014 for two counts of assault on his spouse and child. Gun control did not work. All the massacres that happen are in gun-free zones. Now, who has the strictest gun laws by far? California, of course, but understand, so it is not guns causing this. It is a crime rate spawned by the number of criminal persons residing in those cities and states. So if all cities and states are not created equally, then there must be something other than the tool causing the gun deaths. Gun control did not stop Devin Patrick Kelly from killing 26 people in a church. Gun control laws in California and Chicago have not stopped gun violence. In fact, with the most stringent gun laws in the nation, California and Chicago have the worst gun crimes in the nation. In fact, California and Chicago have the liberals' dream of gun control, and it has been responsible for death and mayhem. Thugs do not obey the law. Gun ownership is how America was able to begin and helps us keep a safe society. Liberals want to control everyone and see gun ownership as a way for people to maintain their freedom. The rash of gun violence we have seen is because liberals have allowed it. They have made sure that insane people can't be put away and are treated as normal when everyone knows they need help. They make safe zones when they know these are just targets for these nuts. Why have liberals made this concoction of death? The answer is simple. They believe, we will give them the ability to legislate control through more gun laws. Being armed is the only way to stop these plans.